Hello there guys and welcome, it is Niron here and today it is time for me to welcome you to round number 10 of this F1 2016 career mode here with Renault, which of course brings us to our home Grand Prix at Silverstone. We want to impress the home fans as a Brit here in this Grand Prix. Unfortunately for us it's going to be slightly more difficult because we don't have an upgrade going into this one. I said last episode for Austria, they were hoping to have a reduction in chassis weight for Silverstone, but unfortunately I forgot to do the upgrade at the end of the Austrian Grand Prix weekend, so we're having to do it here at the British Grand Prix race weekend, which means it'll be ready for Hungary and not for this weekend, which is a bit of a shame, but we may have some more resource points spare to do a second upgrade, and potentially we'll have two big updates coming for Hungary, which should put us above Force India in the vehicle comparison. But as I said, we're at our home Grand Prix, we're looking to impress, and we're going to try and start doing that straight away in practice. There's a little bit of pressure on us, but obviously Lewis Hamilton, Jenson Button, you know, more established names, maybe feeling a little bit more pressure. Just struggling there at the end of the first track acclimatization lap. Can't say that word, apparently. Track acclimatization, there we go. But doing a lot better on the second lap, and we actually only missed one purple, I think, in the end. Or I think by the time we'd finished the lap, we had two greens and the rest were purple. So a pretty astonishing track acclimatization lap. And in the end, we get a score of 565, which blows the purple score right out of the water. And then we just carried on because we might as well going through those gates. Silverstone, of course, is a track that I know pretty damn well. So we're hoping to get quite a lot done in terms of practice programs. You can see coming through Club and Vale here as well. I think it's Vale. I can't quite remember, actually. Coming through the final corner here to beat the first Delta or target time. And we are a tenth up. Unfortunately, we didn't manage to get the perfect score in qualifying pace, only 30 resource points. We did have this interesting moment here down into Club, overtaking two cars that were alongside each other. It did sort of ruin our lap in the end, but it was quite interesting to see going up the inside there of Fernando Alonso and Riho Arianto in one corner. It was quite a nice move. If I can pull off things like that in the race, I'll be very happy. You can see there in terms of session total, 112 and now 409 resource points overall. We, though, having beaten Jenson Button in our rivalry at the end of the Austrian Grand Prix weekend, we're now being dealt another rival by our agent here in the background. No talk of our R&D engineer because we haven't seen him for a while, but we should see plenty of him for the Hungarian Grand Prix. You can see our new rival there is Sergio Perez, the Force India driver who's just above us in the championship. Seems pretty feasible with the form that we're in. Perez is having a very up and down season, some very good results and some very bad results, so we'll have to see how we do in comparison to him in the race. We'll also see how we do in comparison to him in qualifying as we move into the qualifying report. Lewis Hamilton looked determined to please his home crowd, setting the pace from the offset in Q1. A crash for Sergio Perez saw him go no further, whilst Felipe Nasr will be disappointed to start behind the manners. Lewis Hamilton was on top again in Q2 from the other Mercedes of Nico Rosberg. Nico Hülkenberg and Fernando Alonso showed great pace to get into Q3, whilst Giuseppe was caught out by Q2 rain once again, along with Kimi Raikkonen, who will start down in 14th for Ferrari. But the home crowd would soon forget about Kimi Raikkonen's pain, as home favourite Lewis Hamilton took pole at Silverstone.
That felt great. Finally got a lap together and yeah, very, very, very happy, very grateful for the team.
Sebastian Vettel will start second again, with Max Verstappen in a strong third. So it'll be Hamilton on pole for his home Grand Prix in Silverstone, with Sebastian Vettel alongside him making the same front row as we saw in Austria. Max Verstappen took a solid third with Nico Rosberg down in fourth, whilst it's Daniel Ricciardo and Daniel Kvyat on row 3. Williams locked out row 4 with Bottas and Hamasa, then it's Alonso, Hülkenberg, Sainz and Button at his home Grand Prix to round out the top 12. Well, it's starting to become a bit of a recurring theme, unfortunately, for us. Qualifying, again, pretty damn poor, and again, caught out by rain. It was quite a strange one, to be honest with you, because it started raining at the start of Q2, but the weather forecast said that it was dry. And I could tell that because the AI were just doing their normal lap times. Their lap times were exactly the same as Q1 when it was completely bone dry. But for me, it was like really damp and I ended up like 9 seconds off the pace because I was on the wrong tyre compound. But everyone else was still doing the same lap times as they were in Q1. It was a bit frustrating, hence we've ended up down in P16. Unless, I mean, at least we've made it out of Q1, which has been a struggle occasionally this season at our home Grand Prix, but we have got some work to do to impress this Silverstone crowd and to try and get some pretty decent points. Of course, we've got a lot of, you know, to live up to after that second place in that incredible race in Austria. I'm guessing by now you guys have seen it because it was just one of the most incredible races you will ever see. Go and check it out if you haven't already, although I have sort of spoiled it. But nevertheless, Lewis Hamilton is on pole at his home Grand Prix as he looks to finally try and gain some points back on Sebastian Vettel, who's been gapping him since, I don't know, since like the sixth round of the season. I don't think Hamilton's beaten Vettel. It's been quite astonishing. Going into this one, we're looking at a two-stopper, and it's going to be dry for the whole race with a little bit of cloudiness in the sky. You can see Kevin Magnussen and Kimi Raikkonen were also caught out by that sort of wet weather glitch in Q2. They appeared to be the only ones who were going slower, apart, you know, and everyone else was going at their normal speed. So it was a bit of a strange one, but still, we've got to put it behind us. We've got to line up on the grid in P16 for our home Grand Prix here in Britain. The nerves perhaps starting to build amongst ourselves. You know, we've got a lot to live up to. The likes of Lewis Hamilton and Jenson Button up the road. You know, at the end of the day, we've got to try and impress the home crowd. But I'm sure there's a lot of pressure for myself and for all the other Brits on the grid. The grid has now formed and the lights are starting to illuminate. We are starting P16 for the British Grand Prix, round number 10. The lights are on and they are now off. The five lights have gone off and we are underway for the British Grand Prix. It's a decent start. We're going to pass Magnussen down into turn one because he was boxed in by Gutierrez and Raikkonen, but Raikkonen puts the anchors on very heavily into turn one, and Magnussen gets back around the outside of us. Our new rival Sergio Perez is just behind him, P17. We go back up the inside of Magnussen, and now Esteban Gutierrez in that Haas car as well, and we're up to P14. That's two positions gained. Kimi Raikkonen and Carlos Sainz are battling in front of us. There's potential to gain another one here as well, going for a wide line, so we get a much better exit here out of this corner. We're up the inside of Carlos Sainz in that Toro Rosso already. He's getting the slipstream from Raikkonen, but he's boxed in and down into this left hander. We're going up the inside of the Spaniard, who's massively impressed this season, sitting I think P5 in the championship at this point in time. It's going to be a long move. We're going to have to go all the way round, the long way round, if we're going to try and complete this, but it's a lovely move, sweeping around the outside through Woodcut, and now the plunge down towards the amazing corner that is Copse. I wish, actually, this was still the first corner on the track. Kimi Raikkonen is trying to make a move into Copse there, going up the inside, or trying to go up the inside of the Brit Jenson Button. In front of him is Fernando Alonso as well, the two McLaren cars hoping to get some points. Jenson Button hoping to get some points for the first time since the first round of this season, as my dedicated stats guy Alex Cameron in the comments section tells me. If you haven't seen his comments, then make sure to read them, because they give a wonderful insight into this series and series in the past. So I know they're long, but make sure to read them because they are absolutely awesome. But in front of us into Stowe, Kimi Raikkonen is actually trying to end Jenson Button's hopes of a first point score since Australia by going up the inside into Stowe. We lock up and just tap the back end there of Jenson Button. You can see on the front wing camera just how close that looked, and we go round the outside of Kimi Raikkonen, actually coming through the final few corners. Raikkonen, who was hung out to dry there by Jenson Button. Will the Ferrari driver think about a move into Abbey into turn one? No, he does not. He decides against that one. But we are making some wonderful progress. That's four positions gained. We're now past Magnussen, Gutierrez, Carlos Sainz and Kimi Raikkonen. Now we've got our sights set on the two McLarens and Nico Hülkenberg in front of us as well, and even Daniel Kvyat and the Toro Rosso. This has been a very long highlight. We haven't even had to edit this, but now coming out of that left-hander and down the first DRS straight, even without DRS, because we're only on lap two, we go past Jenson Button in that McLaren Honda, and now we're up into P11. What a first lap and a half this has been for ourselves, and it might not even be over yet, because now through Woodcut, we've got to try and get a good exit. It looks as if we've got a pretty decent exit. Ducking into the slipstream with a pretty slow and a straight line, Fernando Alonso in that McLaren Honda. He's currently holding P10, but we're about to snatch that off him down into Copse Corner. It's our first Copse overtake of the race, and we are already into the top 10 with Hülkenberg right in front of us. We think of a move into Maggots and Beckett, but that realistically is never going to happen whatsoever. This is just a replay. I just thought I'd show a bit more of the AI overtakes and stuff in this race, and you guys can tell me in the comment section whether you like that. This is Valtteri Bottas making a move there, a pretty decent move on one of the Red Bulls there. I think that was for P5 in the race. We'll see how high he can get up the order, because Williams need a good result. They've had a poor season so far. Back to us, though, and into Stowe on lap two still. We have gone past Nico Hülkenberg yet again. Incredible stuff. We're up, what, seven positions now in the first two laps of this race? utterly astonishing. We've got Verstappen and Bottas ahead as well. They've just been battling, and between us and them is Daniel Kvyat, the Russian, who of course stood alongside us on the podium back in Austria at the last Grand Prix. This, though, is the battle for P2, and Sebastian Vettel, who leads the championship by 48 points, is making his way through the field up into P2 past Nico Rosberg. But crucially, Vettel was on mediums and Nico Rosberg was on soft, so Rosberg was on the better tyre compound and Vettel is still overtaking him. So Vettel is so OP in this career mode, it's absolutely incredible. On to lap 3, we've got Daniel Kvyat making a move on Max Verstappen, who seems to be struggling. He's been passed by Bottas, now by Kvyat. Now we're thinking of a move, going for a late switch back up the inside. And that is an absolutely wonderful manoeuvre there into the club chicane. We've got a safety car though, because there's been an accident behind. We've locked up because we've been brake checked by Daniel Kvyat. And the stupidity of this AI under the safety car, they just stop when the safety car comes out, whether you're behind them or not. So we've chipped off a massive end fence of our front wing, which is not ideal. So we're going to have to get that changed, unfortunately. But this is the incident behind. We've got Marcus Ericsson, and we've got Felipe Nasr, and the two Sauber cars have hit each other. And for some reason, that brought out a safety car, despite no retirements. Of course, the damage to the front wing isn't that crucial, because we are, of course, on the soft tyres. We're on the softest possible tyres. So we can just come off them, realistically. We're probably only going to do like 2 more laps on them. So we've just basically gained a few, like a free pit stop. And a few other guys have gone with that idea as well. Max Verstappen just behind us is in. Daniel Kvyat, the road is in. There's a Ferrari. There was a Mercedes in as well. I think it was Lewis Hamilton. And Sebastian Vettel's in. Daniel Ricciardo's into the pit lane as well. So Red Bull doing 2 pit stops on the same lap. Going to have a change of front wing, so we will lose out to Verstappen again. We may even lose out to someone else in this pit stop. But it's not too bad. We've only lost 1 position in terms of track position, and then obviously we'll be behind the safety car again, and we'll be really close to everyone else. We decided to go for the hard tyres, because that means that we guaranteed only have to make 1 more pit stop in this Grand Prix after this, because we should be able to go till about lap 18, 17 or 18 on these tyres, and then maybe go to the end on the mediums. So we should be okay. A lot of people around us have actually gone for softs, which is quite confusing, because they're now guaranteed to have to pit 2 more times in the race. Jenson Button in the McLaren, who was just behind us, was one of those. On to lap 6, though, and safety car is coming in, and myself and Max Verstappen haven't actually caught the queue, and Max Verstappen is driving really slowly. He could have caught the queue, but decided he didn't want to, which is quite infuriating. And a few more cars coming into the pit lane, including Kevin Magnussen, who has surely just completely killed his own race by coming in on the same lap as the safety car came in. It would have probably been wiser to come in, you know, when the safety car was out, but whatever the circumstance. We've got to focus on our own race. That safety car has helped us a little bit in terms of strategy, so we've gained quite a few net positions here, and at the moment we are P7. I don't know whether that is a net P7, because there's a lot of different strategies going on. We're just behind Max Verstappen and Nico Hülkenberg at the moment, who hasn't actually stopped. This, meanwhile, is going on down into Stowe. Daniel Kvyat and Daniel Ricciardo trying to go 3 abreast with a Sauber. It almost certainly looked as if it was going to end in imminent doom, but Daniel Ricciardo does, in the end, hold on to the position in front of Daniel Kvyat. On to lap 10, they're getting a little bit wrong through the final quarter, but overall, these hard tyres aren't too bad. We're keeping Fernando Alonso and the McLaren very much at bay. In fact, we're getting away from him, and he's on the medium tyre, so the actual pace of these hards is pretty good. Unfortunately, that for me, the tyre wear isn't as good as the pace I was expecting, and we're actually going into the lead now, but we are going to pit on the next lap because we're on 72% tyre wear already. This track is definitely known to chew through the tyres. I'm quite surprised we haven't actually got a puncture yet. We're on board though with Felipe Nasr, who's actually slowing. Has he got a puncture? His teammate Marcus Ericsson's gone through. And yes, he has. He's got a right rear puncture as the Sauber driver. So we're just talking about increased tyre wear, but unfortunately it has struck Felipe Nasr and he's got a puncture. Meanwhile, we are pitting out of the lead. Unlike Austria, it's not a net lead at the time we were holding it, because we've got a lot of people behind us who haven't pitted yet. Who don't have to pit again, even, whereas we have to pit again. Sebastian Vettel being one, who looks as if he's just going to drive off and take another win. Behind us, Lewis Hamilton and Daniel Ricciardo are into the pit lane, so we're going to have to hope again for a good pit stop here from the Renault boys. It looks like a good one at first, but we're being held again. And the story of our season so far, apart from punctures, is poor pit stops from the Renault pit crew. And we've been jumped by Lewis Hamilton. To be honest with you, I can't say I'm massively gutted about that one, because Lewis Hamilton realistically probably would have passed us anyway. But at the moment, we are P6. We're P6, there's a few slower cars just gone through. But this is looking pretty good, to be honest with you. We're in P6, we've got Lewis Hamilton ahead of us on the harder tyre compound, and behind us we've got Ricciardo on the harder tyre compound as well, whereas we are, of course, on the mediums the White Walls medium tyre compound. In front of us is Fernando Alonso. He's on the hard, so he should be an absolute sitting duck. Someone else has clearly pitted, because we're now up into P5 with Alonso in P4 and Hamilton up the road in P3. He's already dispatched the McLaren, and now it is our turn down the hangar straight. It is a comfortable move down into Stowe. We're ahead even before the braking zone, so up into P4 we go. And it should be comfortable keeping Alonso behind, because we were quicker than him when we were on slower tyres, so we definitely should be quicker than him on quicker tyres. The only difficulty for us will be keeping Daniel Ricciardo behind in that Red Bull. We'll have to see how that materialises. In the meantime, Kimi Raikkonen here is trying to recover from a pretty poor qualifying. He's going alongside Sergio Perez through Maggots and Beckett's, and they've made contact, and Kimi Raikkonen spins off into the gravel. Sergio Perez gives him the hip and shoulder, and Kimi Raikkonen ends up backwards at a point of the track where you really shouldn't be facing backwards, realistically. So poor Kimi Raikkonen has had a shocker of a Grand Prix. Broke a bit of his front wing as well. We were talking about Daniel Ricciardo, a moment ago, and we are having to defend like our life depends on it once again from the Australian, who's really a thorn in our side at the moment. He obviously stole that win from us in Austria, and now we're trying to prevent him from stealing fourth place here from us at our home Grand Prix. Down the first DRS straight, he was looking close in terms of getting through. Down the hangar straight and into Stowe, he's gone around the outside and looks as if he's got the job done. We're going to have to try and make a move into Club. Ricciardo, though, goes defensive. There's still a little bit of a gap up the inside. We force the move. Ricciardo has to give us the space, and we take P4 back. Fernando Alonso watching on from a safe distance behind. He's got his 3D glasses out. He's making sure he watches this fight in high definition for sure. But onto lap 23, down to Stowe again. And Daniel Ricciardo once again is trying to move around the outside of us. We're struggling with tyre wear a little bit, but we should be okay to get to the end. But again, we hold off the Australian. We hold on in front of the Honey Badger. Sebastian Vettel looks as if he's got this one in the bag from Rosberg and Hamilton. But the real fight for the spectators is definitely this one. And of course, it includes a Brit. So they're going to be cheering me on, hopefully, getting ever so close, almost wheel-banging there through Stowe onto lap 24. And once again, we are just about holding on in front of Daniel Ricciardo. He's throwing everything as well as the kitchen sink at our Renault at the moment. Down into this left-hander, and then woodcut. We edge us the Australian there out of road, and this is getting very physical. This is personal now between myself and Daniel Ricciardo. We've got more than enough fuel to get to the end after that safety car period. We were able to fuel conserve, take your pick. We're now, though, having to try and tyre conserve, because we don't want these tyres to explode on the final lap of this race like they did back in Spain and create more heartache, especially at our home Grand Prix, and especially whilst we're in such a good position. Sebastian Vettel showing off monumental amounts of pace by setting a fastest lap on the penultimate lap of the race. We've got a shocking run, though, down the hangar straight, and Daniel Ricciardo is through already. We're tucking back into the slipstream, and even without DRS, we go up the inside. Ricciardo locks up and goes massively wide through Stowe, and that might gift us this position in the long run. We may have just, with that move, managed to hold on to P4 until the end, but we've got to nurse these tyres home. They're on 69, now onto 70% tyre wear on the front left, which obviously gets an absolute pummeling around a track like this. In the meantime, Daniel Ricciardo has lost all that time, and he's now dropped back into the clutches of Valtteri Bottas and Fernando Alonso, both on the hard tyres, and it's a wonderful move from Valtteri Bottas in the Williams to go up the inside, trying to finally claim some well-earned points for Williams, who have been absolutely shocking this season, despite having quite a good car. Onto the final lap, going into the second sector now, down to Maggots and Beckett's. In the meantime, this man has won. Sebastian Vettel has been imperious once again. He puts his fist up in the air, now two fists in the air. He, unsurprisingly, is massively happy with that win, and once again extends his lead in the championship. Now, coming through the final few elements of the second sector and down the hangar straight, it looks as if we are going to hold on to P4. Will Valtteri Bottas, though, hold on to P5? He's got Daniel Ricciardo with the DRS trying to get up the inside into Stowe. This is going to go down to the final corner, I think, but in front of us, as there's a bit of contact between Bottas and Ricciardo, in front of them, we are coming down into the club chicane, and we are in P4, and at our home Grand Prix here in Silverstone, we are going to take a phenomenal result. It is P4 here in Britain. We'll be right back. it is another absolute barnstormer of a race and another incredible result, this time from P16 to P4, and once again the strategy helping us out again like it did in Austria, but this time we actually showed off some really good pace. We actually beat Valtteri Bottas, Fernando Alonso, Felipe Massa, who were all on the same strategy as us. We beat them outright in the race, and then obviously we beat the likes of Ricciardo due to strategy in that one. But oh my word, P4, you'll have seen the rest of the results. Nothing really stand out in all honesty in terms of the results, no real surprises. And Felipe Nasr, the last of the finishers, no DNFs in that one. Vettel now though has a 58 point lead in the championship, absolutely astonishing. Ricciardo up to P3 above his teammate Max Verstappen. Sainz holds on to P5. Rosberg, after getting a second place here, jumps above Raikkonen and a few others. Then it's Alonso, myself up into P9, then Kvyat and Perez, Bottas and Massa down in 12th and 13th in the championship, then Button, Hulkenberg, Grosjean, and the rest. But wow, we're up into P9 now in the Drivers' Championship. Two brilliant results in a row, and of course that pretty good result as well just before Baku in Canada and in Monaco, of course, as well. Four out of the five races we have done really well, and that's now 5 points scoring results in a row, and we are now only 5 points off Force India and Williams in the Constructors' Championship. Absolutely astonishing, but it is not over there, because we've got an upgrade coming, reduction in chassis weight, but you can see that we've actually just about got enough resource points from that Silverstone weekend to upgrade our engine power as well. So we are going to have two monumental upgrades going into Hungary, which should see us massively above Force India and potentially even challenging Toro Rosso to be the fifth best team on the grid in the vehicle comparison chart. So hopefully that leads to some more point scoring finishes from Kevin Magnussen, because we really need some help from him if we're going to overturn the gap that we have in deficit to Williams and Force India and even McLaren in front of us in a Constructors' Championship. But it's all looking rosy, and a fourth place at our home Grand Prix, surely that deserves a like on this video. If you have enjoyed, feel free to smash the likes button. Can we get 100 likes for our home Grand Prix? If you're new around here, then feel free to subscribe. You can see in terms of our rivalry, we're smashing Sergio Perez after a very strong weekend overall. But it's been a pleasure ranting at you guys today. Have a great day, enjoy yourselves, and goodbye.